going on, my friends? Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and I got an email from somebody today, and I just figured this would be a good episode, a non-formal, in front of the studio kind of episode. So this person, Tommy, emailed, "Hey Dustin, I've been following you since my apprenticeship began 2 years ago. Your video has been instrumental in cultivating my skills and knowledge in the electrical trade. I wanted to ask if you would consider making a video, if you haven't already, providing tips, skills, and or experience required for an aspiring, dedicated apprentice to progress into a foreman or superintendent position. General or specific skills, technical communication to elevate my skills. Thanks." Bro, that's a really good question. And honestly, I don't think a whole lot of people that are apprentice level are even thinking on that term. A lot of people don't even start to really think about like the superintendent, foreman kind of thing until they're like much, much older or they've been doing this for a really, really long time. So A, I would tell you, don't put the cart before the horse. Just know you probably got about 10 years ahead of you before you're even going to be ready for something like that. Maybe not, maybe foreman, you know, 5-6 years. But for like a superintendent of a company, depending on the size of the company too, you know, like bigger companies, they're looking for, you know, 10-year kinds of people, because that means that you have come across so much stuff. And by that point, all of the misunderstandings that you think that you understand about code kind of have absolved themselves, and you really get what's going on, and you can kind of help anybody do anything or find any answers and talk intelligibly to like other expert electricians. So that's kind of what I'm thinking. Like superintendent level, I would be looking for somebody that's 10 years plus, maybe like master electrician level, that just doesn't want to run a company. You know, there's plenty of master electricians out there that are looking for jobs. They don't want to run a company, but that's somebody that probably has a decade of experience or more. For the foreman part, just to be running crews, like I think I got my residential license and at that point was running residential crews at my 2 year mark. Now that was probably way too early for most people, but I'm a hustler, dude. Like from the time I started this, I was doing side work way before I probably should have, but it was that the journeymen around me were like, this kid's got something. Like he's gonna stick around. He works, you know, great. He's not off taking cigarette breaks when everybody else is. Like he's fucking working, doing really good work, gives a shit, always asking questions. I was just that type. And so everybody around was just like, yeah, like this, let's put stock in this kid, you know? And so I got to a certain point where one of them was like, hey, I think that you're good to do some side jobs. I've got this like job coming up. Now, granted, again, I have a video, but you shouldn't be doing side work if you're not insured, not working under a master electrician. It's illegal most of the time. You could burn a fucking house down and get somebody hurt. All of that I should say, meanwhile, all of us do side work, right? Like throughout the whole industry, everybody has been doing side work since, you know, like the beginning of all of this shit. So there's a little bit of understanding that I have. All that is to say, alongside my 8 hours a day experience that I was having working for a company, I was always doing side work. So I've always been doing like 16 to 20 hour days for as long as I can fucking remember. I had a kid really young, so I've just had to pay the bills. So all that's just to say, I have worked and worked and worked. By the time I got to that 2 year mark and I got my residential license, I was ready. You know, like I knew what I was doing. There was a lot of things I didn't know still. I didn't know how to size services, and you know, like I didn't even know what the fucking difference between a service entrance conductor and a service was. We didn't have anybody at this company that was like a code guru, and it was just kind of on the job, on the fly as things came up. That's how I was learning. And I would have to like try to dig through the code book and understand what the fuck the codes were and everything. And but at that point, like I was a foreman, you know, and I got an apprentice under me, and I started to learn how to train somebody. And when you start learning how to train somebody, you really start learning a lot yourself, because you have to think about everything at a higher level to be able to kind of dumb it down into an understanding that somebody that has no clue how to do something will understand. So it makes you reinforce your own knowledge and think about things on a holistic view that you've never really had to think about them before. So training people and being in a position where you have a helper under you is a massively important thing, I think, for everybody to do, just because it takes the closed avenue of your understanding and it just opens it wide up and forces you to think about how to explain shit to people. And then it forces you to take on the liability for other people's mistakes, which shows you that you didn't explain things well enough. And it teaches you as a leader how to be a better leader and how to care and how to like really instill the care about your work and stuff into somebody else. So it makes you practice what you preach because you have to start preaching. So you have to start practicing even harder. I love it. But that's what I think you should go towards. You should always just show up every day, do your best work, give a shit about what you do. Always ask questions. If you're working with a journeyman that hates being asked questions, you're with the wrong fucking journeyman, man. I'm sorry. There's some journeymen out there that just don't like answering questions, especially from like green, brand new apprentices. A lot of them are like, I don't want to fuck with any helpers until they're like past their first or second year, because that's where they really understand. And I get it. You know, there's when you get like a brand new helper as a master electrician, it's like, all right, for the first fucking year, you're just going to annoy the shit out of me. I have to show you that righty is tighty and lefty is loosey. Like, we can't even fucking talk about a switch or what a wire does, because you don't know how to use a fucking drill. You know, I get it. I totally get it. But there are some people that just like to teach and doesn't matter where or when, and likes to see the process of somebody evolve. I'm one of them. I love from day one going through an entire apprenticeship with somebody, seeing how they're growing, seeing them do better, seeing them mess up really shitty things. And then later on the line, get it. And you just sit back and you observe them getting better. You know, I don't know. I just really like that, but I like being a teacher. So it kind of takes a different type of person. So anyways, that's all to say, if your state has like a residential kind of thing, that's a good place to start with this. But just understand that it now becomes about somebody else. Kind of like parenting. Once you have a kid, it's no longer about you. It's about somebody else. But in that constantly focusing on somebody else every day, it makes you a better person. Or I think it should. If you care about, you know, parenting and care about your kid, I think having a kid and having to think about somebody else every day should make you a better person. I think having to think about other people, think about your team, think about being a good support person, getting people what they need and everything is going to make you a better leader and a better electrician. But don't feel like you need to lead so early on before you know what the fuck you're doing, because nobody's going to respect you. So you need to put your time in following. Just be a really good follower. Ask when you're done with something, ask immediately like, hey, what else do I need? What do you need? Don't be fucking annoying about it, but you know, like always keep working, always keep busy, do really good work every day, constantly read books, get in forums, ask questions of the people working around you, take the overtime shifts, take the on-call shifts, like really, dude, dive the fuck into this stuff, because most people don't. And the people that do, they're the ones that end up being the foreman and the superintendents. The people that are just showing up every day for a paycheck, they're always just going to be showing up for a paycheck. Nobody's ever going to rely on them to really do anything, because they already know the answer is that person doesn't really give a fuck. So they can't really be dependent on to go further than what they just do every day. But if you're somebody that kind of does the minimum all the time, it's going to be a struggle for you to be trusted as a superintendent, because everybody sees you just doing the minimums all the time. Nobody says anything to you, but you're known as the person that just does the bare minimums or does the shit hack work, or they know like he will never work overtime. He will never fucking take on call. He's always got some bullshit excuse. Those type of people don't make it into leadership positions and don't end up with, you know, the really high pay, because they have a lot more responsibility over a whole bunch of other people. It's people that have kind of proven themselves over time, over many, many years, that have been given extra responsibility because they show the signs of being able to handle extra responsibility, and they volunteer for it. They just seem fucking hungry and they want to do everything. Those are all the people that rise to the top, and those are the cream of the crop, so to speak. So I just recommend being one of those people. Don't really worry about people that like hate on you, because there's always going to be people that hate on you. Don't worry about the working with assholes and people talking shit to you, even though you work really hard. You're going to want to like tell people off like, fuck you, I work so hard. Just don't even, dude. The chips will fall in time where they need to fall. If you're always putting it in, you're always doing really good work, you're like, it's obvious everybody sees you, and you know that when you're not around, people don't have dick to say about you that's bad. You know the only thing they're going to say is, like, this dude works all the time. Or like, who should we get to do this? I bet if we get him to do it or her to do it, like, it'll get handled. You know, like, we can trust him with that. And then you start getting trusted with things. So then after you've gotten, you know, that, you'll get your journeyman's license. And it'll kind of the same process is going to start again, where you have a lot more responsibility, bigger, you know, financial responsibilities, bigger jobs, just more trusted, more responsibility. And the more that you are educating yourself outside of work, the more over time everybody's going to see that you are starting to kind of outpace everybody else. And you're starting to learn a lot more, and you're starting to have answers for things that before you never would have had answers for. And you'll notice that you're going to start having answers for things that other people around you don't have the answers for. And you'll be asking questions that most of the people even above you have no fucking clue. They've never asked the question themselves. At this point, you're starting to ask things because you're starting to understand so much that the little nooks and crannies that all of us don't understand are finally hitting your head. There's some things that we just don't fucking know, man. Like, you'll get to your point with trying to learn electrical theory where you will literally be asking the same questions that top engineers and particle physicists at CERN are asking right now. And there's no fucking answer because we can't see electrons. But once you get to that point of your understanding of being like, oh, wow, there literally is no definition of electricity. It's a whole bunch of bullshit and everybody has contradictory understanding of what electricity is. There's nobody. We don't know. So once you get to that level where you're asking questions, you're seeking knowledge, or you're coming up with theories of things that are not around, that's the point where you're at, like, superintendent level, I think. That's the level where you're able to contemplate things that are above what most people are able to contemplate. Meaning all the other shit you've contemplated and you got an answer for it because you've seen it, you've at least talked, you've heard these conversations over and over. And I think somebody with that kind of wealth of understanding is the person you want being the superintendent in charge of all of the other crews. So I hope, man, this has been, like, probably longer of an explanation. I don't know, what are we at, like, 12 minutes? Oh, that's nothing. I'm way longer winded than that. I got like 30, 45 minute, hour, 2 hour shit. 12 minutes ain't nothing. But that's what I would say, like the who you are as a person, it's hard to say because I'm only me. I'm not every other person. So I can only say what's worked for me, and I haven't worked for, like, a multinational huge company that's been in charge of 500 people. So that would be somebody to ask. Whoa. What the fuck happened, bro? Anyways, the way that I just try to be is just, that's the way that I know how to be. And I know what has worked for me. I think most people around me that work with me or work, you know, around me just know that I'm a hustler. They know that I'm going to put every fucking 150% of myself into every single thing that I do. They know that I know that there are corner... Fuck. Well, I guess it's a good time to just close this whole shit up. Really just, dude, the more that you care about what you're doing, the more you will be seen caring about what you're doing. And the more that you take time to really try to understand things beyond the boundaries of what you're being taught, the more you're going to grow as an electrician. Faster, you're going to go further, you're going to have more opportunities. And the last bit of advice that I have is try a little bit of everything. It's very much like a valuable thing to do as a human, as like a existential, you know, life force on this planet, to find one good company and always stick with them and be Mr. Loyal and never give up because you love those people. But that is going to hurt you in your experience if that company is not so vastly experienced in all kinds of shit. If they just do one kind of thing, you're really hurting yourself as an electrician by staying there. Now, that's not to say that you can't leave and go get more experience in all of the other, like, 50 fucking fields of electrical that there are. And you can come back by the time you come back to their company, you might be superintendent level, and they might look at you and be like, fuck, dude, you leaving was the best thing that ever happened. Welcome back. Here's a bunch of money, you know? But what I think is the most important is, and what I think is great about the union, is they, you have the ability to travel around and get tons of experience on tons of different projects. A journeyman is actually why we're called journeyman, is because you would journey out and go get more experience, and you would journey from place to place, do all of these different kinds of work, and you would build up this huge bank of experience because you've worked all over the place. So still, that doesn't mean you have to traverse long distances, but I would say go to different companies. Like, maybe start out doing residential construction so you can understand how to work on a basic level with the materials. Get into residential service so that you understand how to maintain and how to fix and troubleshoot residential environments. Then go into commercial construction. Get, you know, how to build like big Walmarts and Home Depots and like dentist office and all kinds of stuff like that, restaurants. But then get into commercial maintenance, the service side, and start repairing and coming up, you know, like replacing contactors because fucking lights go out. Learn how to troubleshoot light poles in parking lots with a line locator, and learn how to meg motors and transformer windings and stuff. And then get into industrial, do industrial construction where you're like, you know, some big plant shut down, and just try to go through all of these different environments, both on the construction side and on the maintenance side. Maybe even do some low voltage, like electronic stuff where you're installing or and programming like lighting control systems or low voltage. That was another thing when I was still just an apprentice. I had another company. Bro, I've had a company since I was like 18 years old. I've had just so many companies. Because it's a way for you to write off expenses and get more taxes back at the end of the year. It's just smart money. But I had a lighting, low voltage lighting company. And so I would just go around because it wasn't doing electrical work. I wasn't being illegal by doing it. I was just doing low voltage landscape lighting. So it was more experience that I was getting. And I knew about it because I was actually doing electrical work and doing a lot of this stuff. But it was only low voltage, so I didn't get in trouble. But again, dude, I'm just like, I'm always hustling. I'm always grinding. Right now, I got three fucking jobs. I'm consulting. I've got, you know, like electrician, you have got live wire. Like, I am always going. So just have that kind of energy, man, when you're at work. Like, go, go, go. That doesn't mean go like stupid fast and just be irresponsible. It means like, go to work. When you're at work, fucking work. Sorry, I know this is all over the place. But that's why I made a video, because, bro, you got me with a good topic. It actually made me have something to say. It's been cool doing, like, some of these Q&A videos lately, because I get to go through your guys' answers or your, you know, comments and stuff and actually, like, reply back to them other than sitting here and, like, because for you to leave a comment, it takes all of 5 minutes for you to formulate your comment. For me to go through the comments and reply, I'm still replying to comments for videos I posted 4 fucking years ago. Like, it never stops. So it's so much easier for me just to do it in video form. So anyways, Tommy, bro, thanks so much for this. I hope that helped. Leave some comments below if you got anything else to add. Probably lots of foremen, lots of other people that have gone into leadership that will also have a lot of shit to add, especially on like how to treat people, how to train people, how some people need to have some heat turned up on them. Some people, you kind of have to be a dick for them to understand and for them to work how you want. Some people, you don't have to say shit. They're already beating themselves up. Just letting them sit in their own disappointment of themselves is like the best way to get through. But there's a whole bunch of different styles and theories of how to be a foreman or a superintendent once you get to that point. But I hope this shined a little bit of light on things that you can do to one day get there. Love you, crazy people. See you in the next one. This fucking camera. Just kidding, camera. I love you, bro. I love you. Best Cant music and video.